to the first event of our St. John's Concert Series 2020 and 2021. We'll be streaming all of our concerts this year. And of course, unfortunately, we can't do the first couple of them live. But we will be streaming, and so you can see each and every one of them. For our first concert, we're so happy to have Tom Mueller here from Concordia University in Irvine, and he's playing the organ recital for us today. We wish you God's blessings, and we hope you enjoy this inspiring music.
Tonight's program opens with Bach's Prelude and Fugue in D major. This is an early work, probably composed when Bach was in his late teens or even early 20s. And you see the virtuosity of the developing Bach in the virtuosic pedal scales and arpeggios that occur throughout the piece. One thing that I love about this work is the way in which Bach combines elements of Buxtehude's style, the North German style, along with elements of what was then the modern Italian style, such as we know in the works of Antonio Vivaldi. And you hear this especially in the fugue, which is very violinistic and very reminiscent of Antonio Vivaldi's concertos. I hope you enjoy Bach's Prelude and Fugue in D major. thrilled that tonight's program includes the world premiere performance of a newly composed work for organ, My Seven Versets on Wie schön leuchtet der Morgenstern. This beloved chorale has been in the Lutheran tradition since the late 1500s. We usually sing it with the text, How brightly shines the morning star, associated with the season of Epiphany. This work was commissioned by Bill and Nancy Robbie, and the impetus for writing it grew out of a conversation with them in which they challenged me to consider writing a cycle of seven chorale preludes that would set the text in each of the separate stanzas. So you'll hear seven different settings that all use the same melody, but they vary greatly in the mood and the character of each work. Some of them jubilant and some of them very joyful, but other ones rather quiet and introspective. The specific text or theological image that I chose to represent each setting is included in the title, so you'll see these on the screen as we move through this set of versets. So please enjoy the world premiere performance of Seven Versets on Wie schön leuchtet.
Thank you.
Our next work is Bach's setting of the Agnus Dei in its German adaptation, which we know as O Lamm Gottes, unschuldig. This is probably an early work of Bach's, but he later returned to it and included it in a collection of chorale preludes that he compiled during his time in Leipzig. We know that collection as the Leipzig Chorales. If you think of the structure of the Agnus Dei, it's structured in three verses, two of which end with "Have mercy on us," and the final one, "Give us your peace." And Bach sets this chorale prelude in a similar structure. There's three distinct verse settings, each of which varies in its character and its mood, and I've also used different registrations and dynamics here to highlight the differences between them. One musical illustration that Bach uses to further engage with the text here is that the melody, when it's stated, moves across the texture of the different verses. In the first verse, it's in the soprano, the highest register. In the second, it's in the middle register, threaded among the other voices. And in the final stanza, it's in the lowest register, played in the pedals. And in a way, you could say that it represents Christ's journey from heaven to earth, and even descending into hell during the crucifixion. So it's a wonderful musical setting, and I think a very gripping piece, both musically and theologically.
Thank you.
Percy Whitlock was an English composer and organist of the early 20th century. Unusually among organists, he was equally skilled as a church musician, but also as a theater organist. And oftentimes in his music, you see these two musical identities dueling with and combined with each other. The Scherzetto comes from his organ sonata, which was composed in the mid-1930s. It's the third movement. Scherzetto translates to little joke in Italian. And in this piece, the joke is on us. He writes the piece without a real meter. So most pieces of music that we know have a consistent pulse to them, like a steady beat that we can understand and anticipate. In the Scherzetto, Whitlock actually avoids using any sort of steady beat whatsoever. In fact, he doesn't even bother to include time signatures in the piece because the meter is changing so frequently. So if you try tapping along to this piece, you'll quickly discover within a few seconds of the beginning that it's almost impossible to predict exactly where the next beat is going to land. And so that's the little joke of this piece. This piece also reflects a lot of the sounds and the style of theater organ, especially as we see in silent movie accompaniments from the early 20th century. And the organ here at St. John's has beautiful colors that perfectly fit this style. So you'll hear some of the less church-like possibilities of this organ in Percy Whitlock's Scherzetto.
Thank you.
Before the final piece of today's program, I want to take a moment to thank the music team here at St. John's for their hospitality and work in presenting this concert, Bill, Marianne, and Alex, and of course, Charlie Roche, who has put in great effort to record this and help produce the videos and get everything ready for streaming. So thank you to all of you for everything that you do to support music, both at St. John's, but also in our local musical community. It's wonderful to have you all as colleagues. Bach's Toccata, Adagio, and Fugue is also an early work, like Bach's Prelude and Fugue in D that opened the program. And like that piece, you see a combination of both traditional German elements combined with those of what was then the modern Italian style. However, in this piece, the Italianate aspects are much more pronounced. You especially see Bach exploring elements of the Italian concerto grosso, particularly in the fugue, in which you'll see me moving back and forth between different dynamic levels and manuals on the organ to reflect the change, as we would see in an Italian concerto, between the full orchestra and then soloists or small subsets of soloists. The Adagio is also a wonderful example of a very Italian style, very up to date at that time, with a soloist playing the solo melody, ostensibly accompanied by the orchestra, as represented here by the pedals and the left hand. This is a wonderful work for organ and one of Bach's early ambitious works, and it works beautifully with the organ here at St. John's. So please enjoy, in closing, Bach's Toccata, Adagio, and Fugue in C major. Thank you.